It goes like that. The center of the nose is here, and the center of the nose is there. That means the lips are off. And really, so it's going like that. I can try this. That means that will have to be right about there. So let's try this. Nice thing about clay. Now, the mouth is way off. See how far off the mouth is? That means all of this is off, all of this is off. But at least, this is starting to look right. There. So really the best way to do this is to fill in the mouth. And we're working with what you call bosses and hollows. This is a boss shape, and here it's a boss, and these shapes in here are hollows. So we're primarily concerned about the boss, and we want everything to be in correct position in harmony with one another. Oops, that's the wrong one. So before we try to put any detail in, let's get these bosses in the right position. Sure, the profile is correct. Okay. So the center of the chin is over here. So work from the center out. Getting these bosses proportional. This is bigger and this is tighter. We want to have them proportionally the same roundness. This becomes more apparent when you're carving. So this is good practice to prior to carving. Now, this looks to be about the same shape, overall shape, and everything has to run in harmony with that vertical line, perpendicular to that that horizontal line. So I've lost a little bit of mass right in here. And I see where that we're looking at the steepness of the shadows. This needs to be a little, I'm looking at this roundness and this roundness as opposed to this side of this line. This is flatter, this is rounder. So we're just gonna add a little mass. When you're carving into marble, it's always very disappointing to realize you haven't been paying attention to how round one side is as opposed to the other. So this is excellent practice for sculpting. Remember, this is clay modeling. Clay modeling is different from sculpture. Clay modeling is additive and sculpture is subtractive. Now this rate of steepness is a lot longer than this rate. So I've got to tighten up this curve in here. There's no reason to put in the mouth until all of these shapes are exactly in proportion and alignment. Then the mouth will come easy. Now, stepping back, that line is a little off. Until that is precise, this is a little risen. This needs just a slight more roundness. That was just a little flat. So you're fighting the flatness. You want if it's flat, it kills it. It's not lifelike. Now before we ever do the math, establish this is a nasal labial line. Make sure that it feels pretty much. If you give these simple shapes first, accurate, simple shapes first. Drops. Fortunately, if I make a mistake, I can just add a little bit of clay. This is all practice to carving. As you form the mouth in just the same way. Danger is if I start pushing in with my thumb there, then I'm going to change the roundness. It's best to step back and go in with a slightly bigger tool. You see the face is already improving. Now I'll spend probably about 1 hour more just modeling, but that's not necessary. You can see how the mouth is formed, just exactly how you would carve.